911, what is your emergency?
Is anybody injured or do you need the police?
Okay, and do you know how old
your student is? Respond on SFD band, 6301 Raspberry Lane at Huntington High School, engine 13 and medic 13 in the band room. On a 15-year-old female, conscious with difficulty breathing. Respond on SFD band, engine 13 and medic 13, on streets of 5 Oaks Drive.
My name is Scott Wolfton. I'm the Fire Chief, Shreveport Fire Department. I started my career in 1993, so I've worked 22 years, Shreveport Fire Department. I've worked as a firefighter, an engineer, as a training officer, Chief of Special Operations Safety, and now the Fire Chief. It's been one of the most rewarding careers that I think I could ever be a part of. Well, since 1983, when we entered the business of EMS transport and delivery service, we've evolved greatly. From, I think initially in 1983, we had maybe two or three ambulances that were rented beginning our services. And if you look at us today in 2015, we now have 10 advanced life support ambulances in place for patient transport and providing that advanced life support. We also have three sprint vehicles, single paramedic, rapid intervention non-transport vehicles, also to get advanced life support on the scene as soon as possible. We've also invested in some of our engine companies having that advanced life support capability also. So our goal as a fire department has always been to get the highest level of care to our citizens as it relates to emergency medical services. And that's been our goal all along, and we've kept trying to improve on that goal.
My name's Nathan Tabor. I'm the Chief of EMS for the Shreveport Fire Department. As we were implemented into the EMS service under the tenure of then Chief Dallas Green, we basically were asked to take over the service overnight. So literally the evening before, Fire Chief was notified that the Shreveport Fire Department was going to need to take over the EMS service for the city of Shreveport. They scrambled and had some trucks rented and leased. And the next morning, 8 o'clock, we were in the EMS business. The initial outlay of EMS for us, we went into utilizing it as a division being, even though they were still firefighters for the department, they were now also mainly tasked with doing the EMS part of the job.
Our fire communications division is the only fire communications division in the country that is accredited through CALEA, which means that they have established standards on themselves that they are required to meet. The professional men and women that work at our communications division, I've always told them, this is where the emergency begins. Everything that happens that we do has to come through you first.
911, what is your emergency? Okay, was anyone hurt?
They have a very important and a very tough job because they are trying to decipher information that's being given to them many times under pressure and emotions, and they're trying to get accurate information from that individual, simultaneously sending that information out to our trucks and our stations to be able to get there as quickly as possible. They have a standard where they want that dispatched out to our companies within 1 minute. They want to be able to decipher that needed information, and they meet that standard. They decipher that information, they get the pertinent information that needs to be to get that truck going, and not only that, they're continuing the conversation as a call taker with that person on the phone, and even as our trucks are getting en route, they're giving them additional information.
Okay, we got help on the way. Just be looking out for them and just tell her not to move around, stay in a position of comfort, okay? If something changes, you get worse, give us a call back. You're welcome. Bye-bye.
The majority of our dispatchers have the same level of professional medical training that our firefighters have in operations. And they all certified as emergency medical dispatchers. And that's through APCO. And they have a system in place, a protocol in place. As they receive that information from the patient, they can quickly flip to wherever they need to be at. If the patient calls and says, I'm having difficulty breathing, they can go to that, and they know what questions they need to ask them, that pertinent information they want to draw from them. So working together with that, the communication division, being trained in that emergency dispatcher, and working together with operations, we get the best possible emergency pre-hospital care that we can get to our patients. We have 10 medic units in the city, and they're strategically located in their response. However, we also have 21 engine companies that are even more strategically located because we want to reduce response times. Quicker that we can get there safely, we can provide the best service. If we can put personnel on those engine companies that have that advanced life support capability, can provide that level of treatment, and we can get it there quicker, because odds are one of those engine companies will be able to get there quicker. It's why we recognize the Sprint vehicle also, and it was implemented several years ago. And that's all about getting the advanced life support there as soon as possible.
My name is Clarence Reese. I'm an EMS officer with the Shreveport Fire Department, and I currently have 13 years of service. We provide special services for them. We have all-terrain vehicles that we provide at events. We have a bike team that we can provide at events. We have people on foot with special equipment, condensed equipment that they can carry on their back or on their bike or on their specialized unit. When we have the Louisiana State Fair that comes in, we have, it's fully staffed, just like a fire department, and it's contained to the fair or contained to an event. Within a fire department, the main thing is changing the mindset, letting people know that your fire department is an EMS agency that just so happens to fight fire. One of the other things that keeps us going is keeping up with the trends as far as technology and medicine. We're attached now to different programs such as tactical medic programs, where we respond with police officers, where we're in a time where we have, you know, a lot of active shooter situations, standoffs and things of that nature. We're attached to those special units. EMS is pretty much attached to every specialized team now, and that keeps somebody right there on the scene that is familiar with EMS that can provide care at a moment's notice.
Well, we have to keep our medical directors involved in our EMS transport. And we're blessed in that we actually have co-medical directors. When I say they're engaged, they come to our department, they ride out, they respond to calls with our paramedics. On those calls, they're not only assisting, but they're evaluating. They're recognizing from a quality assurance standpoint, how are we doing things?
My name is Katina Seamster, I'm the Assistant Chief of Training. This year is my 24th year. I think training's role to support the EMS system would be EMT basic training, in which we do for all our rookie firefighters and anyone else that might be on our department for 20 years or more. Advanced EMT training we're going to do beginning in September of this year. Also recertification for our EMTs, our paramedics, and our intermediates. The older firefighters and EMS personnel, we just need to talk to the young ones that are coming on to make sure that it continues in our future.
John Lane, Chief of Training for the Shreveport Fire Department, 24 years of service. Our communities, that's who we serve, that's what we're here for, and the fire service has evolved from just doing from just doing fires. We're our community's homeland security. We're our community's hospitals. We're our community's everything. They depend on the fire service, and we deliver it, and nobody can deliver it better than the fire service can.
I consider myself blessed to be the fire chief for this department and the opportunity to serve the men and women on our department. And I believe that that's my responsibility, is to serve them and ensure that they have everything that they need to provide the highest level service. I also think it's my responsibility to prepare them to be leaders when I'm gone, and the other leaders on our department, to prepare them to step into those roles and continue taking the Shreveport Fire Department into the future and to continue making it better than it was when we arrived here. From the time we started EMS to where we're at now, we have kept moving forward. We have kept getting better. I'm so proud to say that the men and women on our department have a heart for service. They have the compassion in their heart, which is a desire and genuine concern to meet someone in their worst time of need and do everything that we possibly can to make it better. And every day, they exemplify those things. We try to recognize them as much as possible, those that do it. Many don't want to be recognized. That's because it's their calling. And I'd have to say, that's probably number one thing that I see the character of the men and women in our department is they accept this as their calling. This is what God's called them to do, to help those citizens in their greatest time of need. And I'm so proud to be a part of that and work with those men and women. They're not scared of change, because if they were, we wouldn't have changed from 1983 to where we're at now. And we know to continuously improve, there has to be changes. And they recognize that, and they embrace that change. Because our desire and focus is all the same, to provide the best service to our citizens, provide the best EMS service to our citizens, and be the best fire department in the country. That's my desire in my heart, and I think they share that same desire also in their heart. Number one, though, is the heart of service. I think the Shreveport Fire Department exudes that.
Asking the question?
And I'm not going to, you're not going to hear me.
Okay.
So what you're thinking of is you're candidly speaking. That's awesome. I know. You probably feel like you're dehydrated now, right?
Nah. Yeah, you're going
to
be fine.
I seen what Phelan did to them other people. I'm good.
All right. Really great.
I tend to make up a column like I was talking to somebody. That's pretty neat.
Camera. Latonya.
Got it. False alarm, wrong number. I got excited though because it came from medical places.
I know. Can't do nothing.
Based EMS system falls under operations. We do not presently have a division of